This is your first pay-per-view, but not only your first pay-per-view, but it's a great opportunity, like you said, to start a new era of boxing. What do you think about this?
You know, I just really believe that we're in a new era. You know, Floyd stepped out of the ring. Manny is still active. He had a great performance earlier this year. But I just truly believe that his time's up. I mean, listen to his record, man. The dude's a living legend, and he has everything to be proud of. But I just don't believe that he belongs at the top of the sport of boxing no more. And when I dismantle him in the ring, the world will understand why.
Now you say he's slower than people actually think he is. He's shorter, he doesn't pack a punch anymore. Why do you believe all this?
Well, I do believe that he can pack a punch too. You know, I know fighters can carry strength for many years. I know speed dies out around the age of 35. It's fast twitch muscle fibers. This is science. I get this information from my doctors. This is not an opinion, you know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, Manny Pacquiao is a great fighter. I don't think that he's a world-class boxer. He's always made great fights happen. He's been victorious in many of these great fights. He will not be victorious come July 20th.
Now you're going to say you're going to dismantle him. How do you go about doing it?
You know, we start off with the fundamentals. We're going to show him from the basics, my jab is better than your jab. My setup is better than your setup. My understanding of distance and timing, we're going to keep the advantage in the first few rounds for as long as we can. Of keeping some distance and just understanding how eager is Manny to impress his fans, make it a good fight. Is he gonna hop in? Is he gonna take his time? What's Freddie Roach telling him in the corner? How well is he listening? And ultimately, what does he do when he feels Keith Thurman's first punch, that first real power punch?
Well, he says that he wants you to stand in there and go toe-to-toe with him. Are you willing to go toe-to-toe with him?
You know, I like to do a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I am planning on sitting down, going toe-to-toe. Adrian Broner made a mistake and let Pacquiao move forward way too much throughout that 12-round fight. I don't mind fighting off of my back foot, but I do want to put Manny, I want to put more pressure under Manny once when he realizes, okay, I'm in the ring with a bigger man that is willing to move forward. You know, he wasn't pushed backwards. The fight, in my opinion, it played out exactly how he wanted to. I want to rough him up. I want to see how much of that old Pacquiao, that real fighter that he used to be, how much does he have left in his heart at the age of 40?
And lastly, how do you respond to those that say that Manny chose the easiest of the champions?
You know, 22-month layoff. My last performance was not my greatest performance. I told everybody in the pressers and in the interviews, you will not see the best Keith Thurman you ever seen against Jose Cito Lopez. But you will see, now that we brushed the dust off and we get to continuously train throughout this year, we get to use the momentum from that last training camp into this training camp, you will see a tremendous Keith Thurman come this summer, come July. Now, I'm really happy to be back active, to stay busy. My second fight this year, the biggest fight of my career, I'm taking the momentum from my last training camp and I'm going to produce a bigger and better training camp so I can give the fans a greater performance.
And you just said that this is the biggest fight of your career. You're facing Manny Pacquiao, who's 40 years old. How do you plan to beat a guy who's so fast? And as you said on the podium, hip-hop, bunny rabbit, hopping around.
I'm a doctor when it comes to boxing science, you know. I got a doctorate in here. Manny Pacquiao can be broken down very simply as a fighter who hops and fights in spurts. Even though his hands are fast, he's not applying pressure with that hand speed. He's looking for an opportunity to hop on you, and once when he hops on you, he wants to see if he can stay on you. He fights in spurts. He'll throw four punches, then he's done. He'll throw five punches, then he's done. He's in and out, and I just think that understanding his fight strategy, I don't expect to have a new Pacquiao in the ring. I believe that he's going to be very similar to his old self. I'm interested in seeing what kind of adjustments they make with slight head movement, but at the end of the day, once when the gloves are on and we're in the ring trading punches, I'm the bigger, stronger guy, and I believe it will show.
Now, you're called one time for a reason.
That's right.
And you've used words like you're going to crucify Pacquiao. You're going to make him disappear. How do you see the spike going?
Like I said, from July 20th, I will still be champion, and he will still be senator. He will go back to the Philippines, and he will be senator of the Philippines. No longer champion of the world. Manny Pacquiao has lived out his legacy, and I'm beginning mine.
And you heard.
Oh, the right hand. If you fight southpaws as a right-handed fighter, you need to throw the straight right hand. And the reason being is because his jab is his right hand. So when he tries to touch me with his right hand, I can be throwing a harder right hand, not just because of the overall strength, but because his right hand comes from the lead foot and my right hand comes from the back foot. So because it's coming from the right side, when it comes here and I come there and I turn this there, night night, you know, night night. Now you have rabbit soup.
Now you were up there talking. Freddie even said that he's gonna destroy you. Your thoughts on Freddie actually giving you some of the trash talks back?
You know, Freddie. I've heard Freddie talk a little bit for his fighters from time to time. Pacquiao doesn't do too much. I think he's got a little warmed up from all the trash talking experience through the Adrian Broner fight. I think he's enjoying opening up a little bit more. He's like a subtle trash talker. But ultimately, man, it is what it is. You can say this, you can say that. What matters is how you fight. What happens in that ring. But I'm gonna come well prepared. I'm coming to make a statement. This is my life, this is my career, this is my legacy, and we're gonna make big things happen.
Finally, let the fans know where to tune in for this fight, how they can see it.
July 20th, MGM Grand, Fox pay-per-view. You're not gonna wanna miss it. It's gonna be an action-packed fight. It's gonna be a beautiful fight for all fights fans and sports fans alike. This is a fight, one of the greatest fights of the year in the making, right here, right now.
Sean Porter, AKA Spence, who wins?
AKA, this is
Spence. I favor Spence.
Thank you.
For Philippine television, many have tried fighting money and many have failed in the
And 7-16.
What makes Thurman any different?
Well, Manny hasn't fought in too many undefeated champions throughout his career. I'm the youngest undefeated champion that he's probably ever faced. And I know boxing, you know. I was raised in the sport from the age of 7. I had over 100 amateur fights. I had international fights. I was almost the Olympian back in 2008 for the China Games. And I lost in the US Olympic trials as an amateur. I turned pro. I've been undefeated ever since. Manny Pacquiao might have tremendous experience, but not experience against the type of fighter that I am. With the Olympic background, with the understanding of boxing, speed, and power.
Can you say a few words for Filipino fight fans?
Yes, sir. For all the Filipino fight fans, tune in to my fight against Manny Pacquiao, July 20th. Your senator is going down.
Your undefeated record is one of the reasons Manny chose you. How important is it to keep your record, to keep that zero?
Look, honestly, me and Manny have some of the same envisions of the sport of boxing. All I really want to do is go out there and get my best fight. I believe in myself the way he believes in himself. My best performance defeats Manny Pacquiao. I will stay undefeated. He believes that with the proper training, that his best performance, even at the age of 40, can defeat the undefeated Keith One Time Thurman. This is really just a great fight. It's an honor to share the ring with Manny Pacquiao, and I'm just going to, you know, respectfully show him that I'm gonna outclass him. It's gonna be a beautiful fight. It's gonna be a beautiful night of boxing.
Good luck.
Right here. Thank you.